property buying can be often complex. Even absence of a particular document could cause a burden for the home buyer in the future. Therefore, it is extremely important to check all necessary documents before purchasing a property. Check this manual for all necessary documents before purchasing property. Number one, copy of the building plan. Your buyer must accumulate a duplicate of the building plan authorized by the statutory body to establish that the construction of the property is legal and is executed according to the set guidelines and regulations. Number two, sale deed. Sale deed is the most essential piece of paper required for property purchase. The sale deed must be produced in original as it establishes the ownership of the identity of the property. You need to register the sale deed in the sub-registrar's office of the area where the property is located. Then, Khata certificate. It is also an important document for the registration of a new property. It is also required in case you need to transfer the ownership of the property at a later stage. This document is proof that the property has access to the local municipal records and the development has been done according to an authorized plan. Banks ask for this paper before granting you a home loan. No objection certificates. No objection certificate is delivered by several establishments like safety, electricity, water, etc. It is illegal to promote a house without acquiring a NOC. Before making any payment towards the property, make sure that your builder has produced a no objection certificate well in advance to you. Allotment letter. It is also one of the most important documents that will have to be signed by the builder. This could be done after the advance has been made on the land or the apartment purchase. It is issued through a developer or the housing authority mentioning the description of the property and information of the amount paid by the buyer to the developer. Do keep in mind that an allotment letter is not similar to a settlement of sale. An allotment letter is issued at the letterhead of the authority, while a sale agreement is documented on a stamp paper. Moreover, an allotment letter is issued to the first owner and different owners can ask for a duplicate of the original letter from the seller. Sale agreement. This document lists all types of information about the property, the terms and conditions, the possession date, the payment plan, the specifications, the details about the facilities, etc., etc. The agreement also holds the developer liable for the construction of the property. This document needs to be produced in original for property purchase and obtaining a domestic loan. General power of attorney. A power of attorney is a legal procedure used to give authority to another person by the property owner on her or his behalf. And one can either give a special power of attorney or a general power of attorney to transfer one's right over another's over one's rights over one's property. Possession certificate. This is a certificate that will be given to you after you have obtained the sale deed. In different words, this is a certificate that validates the possession of the assets after the individual has physically taken over the property. Payment receipts. Collect original payment receipts from the developer in case you are buying a brand new property. If you are buying a resale property, ask for a duplicate of receipts from the seller to be produced to the bank. Then, property tax receipts. Property owners must pay taxes. Ensure that the previous occupier owner had paid property taxes and there are no pending dues. Property tax receipts additionally help in providing legal status of the property. Finally, encumbrance certificates. An encumbrance certificate is needed to show that the assets do not have any pending legal dues. This is one of the key documents bank ask for earlier than they grant you a loan. This certificate also has all the details related to the transactions that happened over a period of time. Please note that these are all not only the limited documents required to purchase a property. These are all the basic documents might be required to purchase a property. So I would always advise you to consult with a property title expert like a property lawyer before going in for a loan or before going in for a purchase of a property. Hope this video was helpful to you. Stay tuned and watch out for my next videos coming in this week. Until then, see you. Bye.